Hey everybody, it's Steve with Sky194, and I appreciate you taking the time to visit and check out my video. And we are here in my E-Senior Season 8 GT3 Championship, my league race. And of course, we're at Spa, and I'm in my AMG Evo. As you can see, Peter Wolfshiner is in first with 223 points. Johan Larsson is in second with 179, and I am third with 169. So, and you can see the last race, it was first, second, and third between the three of us. So it's really going to be tough because, of course, you have them, you have those two, and I think they all train with each other, I'm pretty sure. And then you got Hellstrom down there in 10th. He does too. So you got a lot of McLarens, and they are really tough here. So it's going to be an uphill battle. Of course, you got Chris Moses in fourth. And the BMW, and Craig Holmes in fifth. So, I mean, all these guys, Derek Bird, I mean, Paulo, I mean, Punov, I mean, all these guys in the top 10 are just super tough. So, again, it makes it a real challenge here at Spa. You know, again, my goal is to try to get on the podium. Let's just see what things, you know, what happens, and see if I can throw a rope out to one of the McLarens and get tagged along or something. So, but let's head over to the track and see what we can do. All right, well, we're back here getting ready to start the race here at Spa. And I qualified. I messed it up. Kind of frustrated at myself right now. So, just miscalculated and just kind of messed it up. So qualified 8th, but the McLarens are like I thought. I mean, they're pretty dominant. I think the top three are all the McLarens, the guys I thought. Chris is up there in the BMW.
Follow car number 701.
You got Chris Holmes up here also. And then you got Bird here right in front of me. So it's gonna be a fight, that's for sure. Hopefully we can get through without any contact. Kind of went on the conservative side, hopefully going for consistency. I definitely can't match performance, so we'll just have to see how it goes.
Side's clear. Right side. Clear right. Car right. Still there. Hold your line. You're still there. Still there. Clear right. Car right. Still there. Still there.
Whoa!
He's still there. Right side's clear.
Wolves leader.
He's now in the lead. Car right. Still there. He's still there. Clear right. Car left, clear left.
Can't get around him. Dang it, that was bad. Some of these McLarens are going with like ultra low downforce. I don't know if that's going to work, but we'll find out.
Steve, we just cut the track.
No, come on. I didn't think it was that bad. Dang. Definitely think this guy has, because he's like super fast on the straightaway. I mean, really fast. Get some push. Just look at him go. I mean, he just starts pulling away, and McLarens aren't that fast on the straightaway, so I think he's got like really low downforce.
Yellow flag. Incident clear. Green flag. Sector 3 is green.
Yes, sir.
Behind is now 0.8. Gap to Nemeth ahead is now 0.43.
Oh my God! Two track limits. Boy, this thing is really being tough. Dang.
stay close. There might be a chance here. Yellow flag. Car right. You're clear. Incident clear. Hold your line. Clear right. Pit window opens in 2 minutes. The gap to Bird in front is now 1.5 seconds.
Go, go, go.
Pit window open in 1 minute. That's a new fastest lap for
World's leader.
218.22.
Fast.
The gap to...
Yes, sir.
Behind is now 1.0 seconds. Incident in sector 1, yellow flag. We can see Carlos has gone off in Radeon. Okay Steve, pit window open. Green flag sector 1. You're reeling Bird in. The gap's now 0.6. Sectors 1 and 2 are 0.30 off the pace. Sector 3 times okay.
try to stick with them. See if I can just slowly close them in, I hope.
Incident in Sector 1. Sector 1 is yellow. It looks like Zimmer has crashed in Radion. Green flag Sector 1. Okay, Steve, stay close. Wait for him to make a mistake. Fastest lap for last 218.11.
Way up there.
Searching, you'll find a gap. Fastest lap for
Wolf's leader.
217.94. Sector 1 is 0.49 off the pace. Okay, Steve, keep piling on the pressure. He'll make a mistake. The track temperature's decreasing. It's now 30 Celsius. You've got half your fuel left. The gap to Bird ahead is now 0.8. Thank you.
starting to pull away a little bit. Our right-side tires need to come up. That might be what's hurting me. Bad here, but they're lower in the rest of the first and second sector.
Fastest lap for last 217.70. Okay, Steve. Lap times are pretty consistent. Captain Bird ahead is now 0.7. Find a way around. We're losing time.
I know it.
Bird ahead is now 0.5.
Yeah, I think it hurts because the tires are low right there. And it makes them just not have the right grip.
Sector one, yellow flag. All right, Steve, stay close, waiting for him to make a mistake. We think Zimmer and Lawrence have gone off in Radion. Sector 1 is clear. You've got 10 minutes of fuel remaining.
Probably running right to the edge. Not doing good in turn one. You do better.
So Bird in front is now 0.7. Send it already.
Pulling away now.
New fastest lap for
Wolves leader.
217.54. That was a 219.19. Sector 2 is 0.6 off the face.
Hang it. Battle it out.
The gap to Bird ahead is now 1.4. Okay, Steve, keep piling on the pressure. He'll make a mistake.
Alright, two more laps. Dang.
gas and fuel remaining for 5 minutes.
Oh, Hellstrom got a drive through.
You've just done 219.38. Sector 3 is 0.7 off the pace. Very little fuel left. Come into the pits at the end of this lap. Box this lap.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to. Dang it.
Fritz, he's pitting from position 19. We think he'll be close in front of you when he exits. Gap to Bird. Ahead is now 1.1. Okay, Steve, very little fuel left. In this lap, box this lap. Leaving the pit lane. Watch your speed limit in the pits. Expect traffic on exit. We expect to exit the pits in position 12, just in front of Parks. We're halfway home. We think about 2 minutes of fuel remaining. Last behind is pitting.
Should have enough. Be close, but it should be good. All right, perfect pit stop. It's Chris.
Parks behind is pitting now. Exit is clear. Watch the white line. The leader.
Wolves leader.
Is pitting. incident sector 3, yellow flag. We think
Mecca
has gone off.
Hang it.
Green flag in sector 3.
That hurt. I really needed to get around him.
Okay, Steve. There's a car exit in the pits. Heads up. Nail him already. P5.
Birds a couple seconds behind. Tough race. Great race.
Steve, keep piling on the pressure.
I think what it is you get behind them and you get the dirty air. And it starts to get a little understeery. It makes it really hard to pass.
Yellow flag, sector one. It looks like
Molescu.
The sector in Radion. Green flag in sector one.
Too deep.
Reactor homes in front is now 0.9. Good consistency. Keep them coming. See, Carlos has gone off in Lacoon. Sector 2 is clear.
Yeah, I lost 3/4 of a second there.
Sector 1 is yellow. We think that Zimmer has spun off. Green flag, sector 1.
Too deep.
Okay, Steve. Relax, focus, keep it smooth. That's 20 minutes to go. The gap to Holmes ahead is now 1.0. Fastest lap for
Wolf's leader.
217.26.
Wish we could catch up to Larson up there.
There's gotta be a chance here. Keep hurrying him.
Some pulling away from Derek anyway. Not much, but a little. That's better than nothing.
Sector 3. We think.
Yes, sir.
The stacked it in. The chicane. Green flag sector 3. Sector 2 is now yellow. We think that.
Mac
has gone off in Lacoon. Green flag sector 2. The gap to Holmes ahead is now 0.8.
He's gone off so many times, but he hasn't got a drive-through, so I don't know.
All right, Steve. Stay close. Wait for him to make a mistake. That's 15 minutes. Stay calm. Keep it smooth.
Almost hit him. My marks. Too worried about him. Messing up.
Left. Wasting a lot of time here. Get your elbows out and force the pass.
Trying.
Your last lap time was at 2:19.12. Pit window closes in 2 minutes. Stay close, wait for him to make a mistake. Pit window closing in 1 minute.
Ah! Dang it!
Five. Okay, Steve, stay close. Wait for him to make a mistake. Left, 10 minutes to go. Pit window is now closed. Sector 2 is 0.7 off the pace. Lap times are pretty consistent. Captain Holmes in front is now 0.8.
Man, what a tough race. This is a workout.
Temperature's decreasing. It's now 28 Celsius. Left side, clear left. Fastest lap for
Wolves leader.
2:17.02.
Man, he's flying.
Find the gap. Sector 3 is 0.8. Off the pace. Mm-hmm. Yellow flag. Green flag, you're clear. Okay, Steve, keep running on the pressure. He'll make a mistake. Last lap was at 218.86. Sectors 2 and 3 are 0.6 off the pace. Sector 1 is 0.5 off the pace. That's 5 minutes to go, 5 minutes. Okay Steve, come on, stay focused. Apexes and exits, apexes and exits.
I'm trying. He's making little mistakes.
Okay, mate, watch for a mistake. Got 10 minutes of fuel remaining.
He's been way off there like every single time.
All right, Steve, stay close. Wait for him to make a mistake. Left side. Hold your line. Clear left. Right, the guy ahead of us is Holmes. Holmes ahead is increasing. It's now 0.6.
Yeah, that hurt. That didn't help me. And I mean, I should have gained on him or passed him. And instead, he pulls more. That didn't help.
In incident in Sector 3. Sector 3 is yellow. 2 minutes to go. 2 minutes. It looks like Lawrence has gone off in the chicane. Sector 3 is now clear.
It hurts me that I got the 3 out of bounds. That hurts. Last lap.
Last lap. The lap time was at 2:19.36. Yellow flag, sector 3. It looks like
Mechner
has crashed in the chicane.
Had to settle for fifth.
Green flag in sector 3. Five. Okay, it's over. Well done, mate. Good finish.
That is what it is. You know, I just couldn't do any better. I think I was faster than Holmes, but you know, that'll mean nothing if you can't get around. So, but it's the way it goes. You know, just the way it is. Probably went a little bit too conservative on the setup. I think I should have just a little bit more free, especially, you know, again, see, that's where it really helps when you're, what do you call it? You know, basically testing it in real circumstances, because in the drafting, I could tell it was basically had a little bit of understeer, that dirty air. And I think maybe if I would have had the car a little looser, that it wouldn't have made it that, you know, that big a deal. So maybe, you know, I had it fine for when I was by myself, but as soon as I got behind some dirty air, it just, you know, the thing would just start to understeer more than I needed to. And then I know I'm just scrubbing speed and scrubbing my front tire. So again, just something, it was simple adjustment. But I mean, the car is really good. I mean, you know, you can push as hard as you want pretty much. So I'm really happy with that, but we'll come back here and go over the setup. We'll come back to spa and after I take a breather and, and we'll come back. Alrighty, back here at spa. Took a break for a minute, took a little bit breather, and then did some laps, trying some different things, but you know, nothing really jumped out at me, and the feel of the car didn't really improve. So I just made a couple of small adjustments on what I used in the race, mainly trying to get it to accelerate off the last turn, the chicane there, and off of turn one. That's where it was killing me. I was not getting the drive out of there that I needed. So I tried a lot of different things, different rear sway bar and diff combos. So I still not perfectly happy with it, but it's better than it was, staying off the TC. So basically, other than that, I think it's pretty much about the same as it was in the race, and we'll talk about it. So we got 25 on the front and 24.8 on the rear. Tow is a -0.1 with the camber at -3.8 and the caster at 12.1. The tow on the rear is a +0.05 with the camber at -3.3. Here, really nothing to really try with this type of setup. Everything is pretty optimized as far as temps are perfect on the tires. Here we go with the electronics are 3-3-1. Fuel, 60 liters. Number one brake pad. Again, tire wear was excellent. Anti-roll bar 5. Brake bias is 55, and you can go down to 54 with no problem. Steering all the way down. Springs are 171,000 in the front with a 500 bump stop rate and a 15 bump stop range. And on the rear, the springs are maxed out at 131,000 with a bump stop rate of 700 and a bump stop range of 45. Anti-roll bar is 7 and the diff is 140. Now, this is where I really spent some time in this after the race here, trying to get this thing to get some more rotation but not over-rotate, and that's where it's really, really tough. And that's where I try to get the diff, too, because in the chicane and in turn one, I'm really wanting the car to pick it up a lot quicker without getting into the TC. So I think I took about half of that out as far as the, you know, it getting into the TC, I think it is improved, but it's still not where I want it to be. You can again mess with, you can maybe go to an 8 anti-roll bar, but again, you start to get too much rotation on that double left there where you have a lot of issues. And so, I try not to get too much. You really kind of almost want it on the ragged edge as much as you can handle, because it's probably going to start understeering a little bit as you go later on in the stint. But the biggest thing is if you're behind somebody and you need the car to be free so you can make a pass, that's when you really need it, because when you do that, you need the car to be able to still turn and rotate and be able to, you know, get alongside somebody. So, I would keep it around here. You can maybe go up to 8 or something like that if you want to try it, but this should be really close. And this is a pretty big improvement, a big difference of what I had in the race. But I tried a real low diff. I tried it all the way down to 60, and it even got worse. It was just all over the TC. I mean, just pretty bad. And in the anti-roll bar accordingly. So, again, it seemed to be better when I added more diff to it. But, again, you need to get that anti-roll bar to help the car rotate, otherwise you'll get an understeer. So that's why I try to work on the both having a good combination where they work together. Shocks on the front are 1153 and on the rear they're 1125. All dialed with Motec. Actually come out really good. Aero 50 in the front all the way down. 74 in the rear with an 8 splitter and a 10 wing and a 3 and a 2 in the brake ducts. And the front aero variation is a negative 2.3. So that's the setup. Again, this is all the same as I had in the race. If you want to go down to a 9, you can try it. I tried that. I tried an 8 and a 9, and the speed is the same. It's at an 8, I don't even think it's a half a mile an hour. So, I mean, it's so close. So it really doesn't make that big a difference. I just went with the 10 in the race. And actually, this setup with low fuel, I ran a 217.86 or 82, something like that. And when they were practicing before qualifying, on their server, on the e-senior server, if I could talk. So actually it's, you know, a good time for me, 217.86 or 82, something like that. So again, really happy. And this is the exact same setup other than the diff and other things I changed here. So it's got speed. The only thing I had was low fuel on it. So again, a lot of it's driver too. You got to really be pushing it and really attacking the corners and the brakes and all those things. So again, just, you know, a lot of it's behind the guy behind the wheel. So, but I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you give me a like and subscribe. And again, the link to the setup will be in the description along with my Discord link. And I hope you all enjoyed the race. Really good race. Congratulations to the podium, the guys on the podium. And I'll go, of course, great race with Craig Holmes and Dark Bird. Again, really good tight battle, fighting it out. So again, I really appreciate everyone's support, and I hope you come back and visit again. Y'all take care. See ya.